Y'all mention names, but I can mention the impact. At times it is difficult to express myself, but the intent is equally the same. You have gained a permanent part of my heart. I have told y'all individually, and if not, I'm saying it today in front of everybody. As for everyone else, I truly wish you the best in life. Don't give up on your dreams, continue to flourish, believe in yourself, be kind, and help someone in the way, and truly find your way to the path. I am sincerely excited for what the future holds for all of you. Today is graduation, not simply high school graduation, but a much greater, deeper one. Today we graduate to a new level of understanding of who we are, and what we can be. God bless you all, and congratulations to the class of 2018. Thank you.
He will be graduated with a final GPA of 4.29.
Wow.
pursuit of degree in biochemistry. Ladies and gentlemen, it is an honor to present the valedictorian for the class of 2018, Cameron.
Excuse me, everyone.
Yo, Cam, you cry if you want to.
Yeah, boy. Good job.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Is that the best we can do?
Good morning.
I'll show you how we do it. Class of 2018, can I hear y'all make some noise? That's my fellow graduates. Over the last 4 years here at Dr. Charles E. Brimm Medical Arts High School, we have learned a lot. Ms. Chen, our math teacher, taught us how to use derivatives and integrating to optimize real-life business scenarios. Mr. Hunley, our English teacher, taught us that Shakespeare really wasn't as boring as it seemed, and that to be or not to be is the real question. And Mr. Karkinen showed us it's okay to love your work life more than your home life sometimes. I say this after learning 10,000 years of human history and spending countless after school hours with this guy, who, in my opinion, spent less time with his own children. And all of this knowledge will no doubt be valuable as we go forward in life. But I think the most important thing we have learned over the last 4 years is that we need each other more than ever. Look to that person on the left or right of you and wonder how life would be if there was no one to work with, compete with, or grow with. Over the next few minutes, I'd like to talk about what we learned, the people we have to thank, and the people we have to remember. I told you that the most important thing we have learned was that we need each other more than ever, especially in today's times. Believe it or not, all of you are reasons I am up here today. Let me give you a couple examples of what I'm talking about. Occasionally, let's say a large packet of homework was due in about a month. And when you team up the book club with people like Danica, Ashley, Nairasia, with brainiacs such as Ibn, Esmeralda, and Siani, and tech-savvy guys like Edwin or Victor, the job is much easier. Another example includes our march to having a banging homecoming. You know we had to leave our legacy in one of the year's best night parties at Brimm. We have strong advocates like Chance, Jayana, Destiny, and Anaya, who fought to make the best ideas a plan. And force Abram, our class advisor, to make it happen. Lastly, we have people like Juan, China, Marche, Kashmir, and Leah. Who didn't allow people to walk down the hall with their heads down. These people helped those in low spirits and generally lifted morale in times of depression. More personally, I like to tell a story of my experience of getting out of my comfort zone and realizing that it's not a solo marathon. This story involves you, Ms. Luke. Since freshman year, you've seen something in me I never saw in myself. Confidence and faith. It was that freshman year, I was almost failing your class with a D+, 73. I came to school late, I missed out on homework assignments, and I lacked a work ethic. But you held me after class that exact day after we took a blood flow and a heart exam. And you told me I had to pick it up. You told me that there are no handouts in this world. I followed by telling you, I'll pass your class. Keeping in mind that a health course is the mandatory class to graduate. And while I finished that year with an A, I proved to myself that anything is possible unless you limit yourself in your imagination. I work endlessly to continue proving myself, and that's where you've seen the leader and pioneer in me. You promoted me to Child Hound President, where I spoke out at state events, we rescued animals, and I advocated for the voiceless. I never knew I'd be the face of an organization, more or less involving animals, but she kind of threw me out there anyway. So Ms. Luke, I want to thank you. Can you please stand and can the audience help me applaud her? Thank you. I'll finish the story by saying, nothing we accomplish is done alone. Rather, we need each other for support and coaching. At one point in life, we've all been on either side of the shoulder to lean on. Next, I'd like to take a moment on behalf of myself and my fellow graduates to thank the people that brought us here. Parents, you brought us into this world. You showed us the ropes and guided us to this point. What else is there to say? Parents, don't ever think we take you for granted. We're just on a mission to show the forever changing world who we are. I'd like to shout out a couple important family in the audience. Mama, love you. My dad, I'm glad you could make it. I love you. And my grandpa, I love you. My mom taught me that life goes on and progressing is the only way to grow. Thank you, Mom. Next I'm gonna talk about some teachers I wanna thank. Mr. Abram, you showed us multitasking skills unlike no other, and at the same time, commitment to work. Abram would come into class, put a math problem on the board, and then walk out. I'll find him in the hallway talking to seniors, or kicking people back in their classrooms. And then he had the nerve to throw a test on us that same day. Mr. Rivera, you showed us tranquility. You gave us techniques like law of attraction, mindfulness, and meditation to make a high school senior stress decrease. Thank you for putting up with us. Next is Dr. Fine. You have earned the nickname, The Plug. You helped us get opportunities, internships, volunteering that we couldn't find anywhere else. And I really loved your exposures class. Next is Ms. Wallenberg. Yeah! Yeah! You showed me that art is more than drawing and painting. It's a way of life, a way to express life, and to deal with life in therapeutic ways I've never seen before. Thank you for that. Next we have Ning Lao She, our Chinese teacher. You showed us the ins and outs of a different culture. You inspired me to take Chinese in college. I look forward to having a fluent conversation with you in Mandarin one day. Lastly, I'd like to thank some supplementary people in my life that helped me. We got the chant program. Led by Miss Noni, who guided me on my track to college. We got Miss Hall. For dealing with my proactive nature of knocking and visiting her office every day. We have Ms. Holmes and Ms. Goodman, who gave me pointers and techniques and strategies with communication and business. And we got Ms. Garen, our principal, for keeping it real with me in times where I was too idealistic or underestimated myself. Finally, I'd like to take a moment to remember any classmates, family members, friends, and teachers that are not here with us today. I want to thank God for everyone here today, as another day is not promised. Again, look to the left and your right and realize that the person next to you is more special, one of a kind, than anything else. So now, we're high school graduates. And soon, we'll finish signing each other yearbooks and saying goodbye. There will be hugs and tears. We'll do our best to stay in touch. But we'll be living our lives and doing our best. As a final thought going forward, I'd like to leave you with a quote from Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., key factor in the civil rights movement. He said, "If you can't fly, then run. If you can't run, then walk. If you can't walk, then crawl. But whatever you do, you have to keep moving forward." Thank you all.
Staff, custodians, security officers, everybody here, thank you for everything you do. Students, I'm going to tell you one thing that I know your parents, grandparents, aunts, uncles, everyone who supported you along the way will agree with. Enjoy today. Make the most of it. Take a million pictures. Sit in that savoring, right? Sit in the revelry of it. But the thing I want to tell you is it's going to get harder before it gets easier. Going to get harder before it gets easier. But know this, if you've gotten this far, you will go as far as you want to go. Congratulations, class of 2019.
Even today, I can see the reflection of myself in your eyes. grew up in your neighborhoods. Your bodegas are that you frequent are the same ones that I frequent. Those two hallways that comprise Brimm are the same hallways that I walked in, played in, and to the frustration of many security guards, sometimes ran down. The restlessness that you feel as you sit in those seats waiting for me to finish this speech so you can graduate is the same restlessness that I felt when I was sitting in those seats. We are cut from the same cloth. I grew up in the Kramer Hill section of Camden, New Jersey. I was raised by a single mother, and I've known the struggles that come from trying your best with limited resources. I've felt your frustrations, and I've shared in your joys. You represent who I am, where I've come from, and all that I am meant to be. This is why I'm here today. I'm here because I'm invested in your future, in our future. These past 4 years at Brimm have provided you with skills, tools, instruments. They've taught you how to think critically. Your teachers have invested their time, their energy, into preparing you for the journey that awaits you. You've grown here. You've made best friends here. You've experienced heartache here. Spent late nights on the phone, and many mornings struggling to stay awake during first period.
Amen.
You've participated in science fairs, learned to critically analyze literature, and I've also learned that there are 206 bones in the human body and that the femur is the largest. I can still name most of them. These experiences, this wealth of knowledge, and the skills that you've developed, well, it's just the beginning. The journey ahead of you will be long. It will be lonely, and sometimes it will be scary. It will be filled with self-discovery, successes, and losses. And to be honest, you will sometimes want to quit. And there is no advice that I can give you today that will change any of that. But what I can leave you here with are three life lessons that I've learned and continue to learn along this journey that is life. Lessons that have kept me sane, lessons that have kept me honest, and that have helped me navigate even in the darkest of times. So if you're zoning out and you haven't heard anything that's been said today, I ask that you listen to this and you walk away with these three things. Be true to yourself. Know that accepting help is not a form of weakness, and know that you are magic. Be true to yourself. At college, I wanted so bad to succeed. I recognized very early on that I was surrounded by people who did not look like me, did not talk like me, and did not share similar life experiences as me. And so faced with this lack of community and with this fear of failure, I convinced myself that success meant that I needed to mirror my surroundings. I was so concerned with fitting in and meeting metrics that were set out. See, at college, they float this amorphic idea of what success is, and I wanted so hard to reach out and grab that idea and mold it and twist it into something that would fit into my life. But what they don't tell you that as students of color is that you have to navigate a world and navigate institutions that you've been historically excluded from.
Come on.
The idea of success looks different for us, and it's not as easily as attainable as it is for others, particularly our white and more affluent counterparts. And I spent such a long time fighting imposter syndrome, being unhappy, I was lost. And it took almost losing everything, losing myself and all the hard work that I put in here to wake me up, to make me realize that success is not a linear path. Success is not one size fits all. The idea...
All right, girl.
That the idea of what success means to me, what it means to you, will change just as much as you will. And what matters most along that path is that you be true to yourself. We focus so much on what we want to be. I wanted to be a lawyer. I wanted to be an advocate. I wanted to make my family proud. Some of you want to be doctors, engineers, nurses, CEOs, and that's a beautiful thing. So long as you remember that who you are is infinitely more important than what you are. Because I can stop being a lawyer, and you can change careers, but my work ethic, my conviction, my grit, but who I am is my constant. My success does not stem from being a lawyer. My success stems from being true to myself, to prioritizing happiness over dollar signs, and what is right over what is easy.
You go ahead, girl.
And that is where your success lies. The path is long, and you will face obstacles. You will face trials and tribulations. You will be tested. But you must remember to remain grounded and who you are, and everything else I promise you will follow. Secondly, remember, it takes a village. My biggest mistake in college was thinking that I had to go at everything alone. You are not alone. Look around. Look at your classmates. Look at your teachers. Look at the family and friends that are gathered here in this room today. The love, the faith, the years of dedication, the sacrifices that have been made for you, all of it is a testament to your greatness. In those moments when you were lost, and believe me, there will be moments when you were lost, I'm still lost. Remember that the weight of the future, the weight of your future, is not rested solely on your shoulders, because it takes a village. You will stumble, you will fall, and when you get to that point of giving up, hold out your hands and accept help. Because we are stronger together, and the future is brighter when we learn to rely on each other. Accepting help is not a sign of weakness, and in fact, it's actually a sign of strength. In moments that I feel lost, the one thing that I do is go home. I go back to my mom's house in Cramer Hill, I visit the bodega, I grab myself a juice, I go home, I eat some pastelillos, I smell some sofrito. Yeah. I listen to the dirt bikes that are really loud in my neighborhood. And I find healing in that, because I know in those moments, it is where I came from that made me who I am.
Yeah.
Remember that, because what you have gone through, what you have gone through to get here is more than any of your counterparts when you go to college have gone through. So remember that home is where the heart is, and it is also where your strength lies. And lastly, I want you to remember that you are magic. Everything that you need to succeed is already inside of you, waiting for you to feed it, waiting to be cultivated. The sky is not the limit, it's only the beginning. And I would be shorting you if I said that you are a star. You are the galaxy. Your success is infinite. That night sky is your blank canvas. Do not let yourself be limited by stars. So shoot off and continue fighting, continue shining. This is your moment, this is your future. Fight for it, cherish it, and remember, you are not alone. I believe in you, I see your potential, I believe in you just as much as I believe in myself. You are magic. And don't let anyone tell you differently. Before I leave you all today, I think it's really important that we thank the people who got us here, the people who brought us here, made today possible. So thank you to all the parents, to the families, for shaping these bright scholars into the people that they are today. Because who you have, the skills that you have taught them are skills that are gonna follow them throughout their whole entire lives. So thank you, and give a round of applause to the family, the friends, and all that love that's here. Thank you to the teachers, to the thankless school years, to all that hard work you put into the summer, to the curriculum writing, to sometimes having to put some students out. Thank you. Your hard work does not go unrecognized. The foundation and the tools that you provided these students are going to help them succeed in the future. And now I want to thank the graduates here today, because this is your moment. This is your time to shine. This is a reflection of all of your hard work, of all of your long nights working and making sure that assignments get done, applying to colleges, 100% acceptance rate.
Yes.
Now I challenge you today to make that 100% graduation rate. Yes. Because this is just the beginning. There's a long road ahead of you, and yes, each and every single one of you have the potential and have the skills and have the tools and have the support needed to make it there. Success is what you make of it. Success is what you make of it. Don't let anyone tell you that you need to be a doctor or a lawyer or anything else to be successful. You need to be true to who you are and remember where you came from.
Mommy.
And know that this is just the beginning for you. So to the graduates, I want to ask that we all give them a round of applause.
Full paid tuition. AA scholarship, $1,500.
Tour.
Asia Robinson.
We're going to now announce the students to come up and receive their diplomas. I'd like the second row to rise, please. I would like our staff members, our administrative team, to please come to the front. Denise Coleman. Ivan Coleman. Jameel Coley. Yamilet Cox Martinez. Jelica Cox Martinez. Danica Cranshaw. Dominique Cranshaw. Victor Crespo. Edwin Gonzalez. China Felix Spady. Zarecia Fenton. Marche Fisher. Genesis Gonzalez. Jasmine Kalia Holmes.
I love you.
Cameron William Klotz. Destiny Land. Yanira Martinez. Siante Jasmine Mara. Azeem Moore. Erica Latia Muse. Esmeralda Pena. Wisdom Perez. Ashley Pintor. Rabria Pollitt. Samaj Allen Reed. Nairasia Robinson. Juan Rene Rogan. Kelvin Javier Rosario. Leah Janae Rosario. Siani Scott. Yeah. Spanish meter annually.
At the workplace. place and mostly do good for your country in this very important and very difficult time. So, congratulations to the class of 2018. I sincerely wish you the best of luck. To you, the class of 2018. Yes! Because on this day, the 27th of June, this class has met the New Jersey state requirements for graduation. So at this time, I ask you to move your tassels from left to right to left.
Against the weak, that makes you a villain. I would want you all to be heroes. Congratulations, class of 2018, and best of luck to all that you do.
Special thanks to my partner, Ms. Brady. I could not do the work that I do without Ms. Brady. Thank you very much, Brady. Behind the scenes, I'd also like to thank Ms. Goodman, who did a lot to put all this on, and we would not be here without her today. Everybody else that helped, sorry, it's too many to name at this time, but we greatly appreciate all that you've done. So on behalf of the senior class of 2018, thank you. Express emotion to each one of you individually or ever. That's intentional. Okay, we always leave them wanting more. But guys, the last time that I'm going to address you formally, and yeah, I do want to take a moment to say that I do genuinely care for each and every one of you, no matter what my emotions might be that day. I promise, I really do. And know that you always have a family at Brimm that will be here for you. So please stop by, please come back, and please remember to take all of what was said to you today and do good in your community. Thank you.